For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Hawaii Temperature 1 from your sample files folder. A brand new feature for Excel 2013 is its ability to recommend a chart type to use with any specified data. Excel can now intelligently analyze your data and then try to guess which chart type will do the best job of representing it visually. It's often a very good starting point for further developing your chart designs. This worksheet contains temperature data for Honolulu, Hawaii, one of the nicest year-round climates in the world. I'm going to use the Recommended Charts feature to select a suitable chart type to represent this data. So I'll click anywhere within the range A5 to C17. You could also select the entire range A5 to C17, but as you learned in Lesson 5.2, when you want to chart an entire range, it's only necessary to select a single cell within the range. Now let's use the Recommended Charts feature. I'll click the Insert tab on the ribbon, and in the Charts group, notice that there's a Recommended Charts icon. I'll click on Recommended Charts, and the Insert Chart dialog appears. And in the left-hand pane, you can see all of the charts that Excel's recommending. Let's look at them one by one. The first suggestion is a line chart, and that does quite a good job of representing the data. Second suggestion is a clustered column chart type, and that also works well. The third suggestion is a stacked area chart. Well, that doesn't work at all with this data. Next, we have a stacked column. And once again, that would be a bad choice for this data. Then we have a scatter chart, and that doesn't work for me. And then a 100% stacked column chart, which again, doesn't work for me. So I think the choice is limited to the first two recommended charts, the line chart or the clustered column chart. And for me, the clustered column chart works best. So I'll click OK. And the recommended chart is embedded within the worksheet. This chart does a very good job of visually showing the temperature range for each month in Hawaii. In Lesson 5.5, you're going to learn how to change the chart title element to display appropriate text. Let me now show you an alternative way of creating a recommended chart, this time using Excel 2013's new Quick Analysis button. So I'll click just inside the border of the chart to activate it, and then press the Delete key to remove the existing chart. Now, to use the Quick Analysis button, you can't just select one cell within the range. You need to select the entire range, including the labels. That means cells A5 to C17. And when you do this, notice that a Quick Analysis button appears on the bottom right corner of the selected range. I'll now click the Quick Analysis button, and you can see that one of the menu options on the dialog is Charts. So I'll click Charts, and you're presented with a choice of 5 recommended charts for the range selected. Now, this is one chart less than when using the ribbon's Recommended Charts button, but you can still preview each chart type by hovering over the appropriate icon. So I'll hover over Line, and there's the Line chart, Clustered Column, and the other recommended chart types. I'm going to select the Clustered Column again, and when I click, exactly the same chart is embedded within the worksheet. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Hawaii Temperature 2. And as usual, I'll save into the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.4. Create a chart using the Recommended Charts feature.